Now the topic is electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. Okay, now earlier, as we know that earlier, people thought that current and magnetic field both are different. Then, because of experiments done by Oersted, they came to know that there is some relation between current and magnetic field. That is, flow of current through a wire will give some magnetic field. That is, if you have current and if that current flows through a wire, you'll get magnetic field. Now the question is whether the reverse thing can happen. That is, if you have magnetic field, can we generate current through that magnetic field? That is the reverse phenomena discovered by Oersted. What is that reverse phenomena? Means if you have magnetic field, can we get current or not? Okay, the answer for this is yes. This is given, what you call, the answer for this is given by Faraday, by a phenomena called as electromagnetic induction. Okay, now what is the definition of electromagnetic induction? The definition for electromagnetic induction is, it is the phenomena in which electric current is induced in a coil by varying magnetic field in the coil. Okay, by varying magnetic field in the coil, this phenomena is called as electromagnetic induction. So what is electromagnetic induction? It is the phenomena in which electric current is induced in a coil by varying magnetic field in the coil. This phenomena is called as electromagnetic induction. Now Faraday said this phenomena by certain experiments. Now let us see those experiments. All these experiments are known experiments. What are the experiments did by Faraday? The first one is, see, what did he do? He took a coil like this. He took a coil like this, which is in YZ plane. That is, this is, I'll take this as X axis, this as Y axis, and this is your Z axis. Now coil is in YZ plane, and he placed a magnet on X axis. Now to this coil, what he did is, he connected a galvanometer to this coil. As we know that galvanometer is used to measure the current, whether current is flowing in the circuit or not. Okay. Now, see, what did he do? You assume that coil is in YZ plane and magnet is on X axis. Then what did he do? He started, see, take this as North Pole, take this as South Pole. He started moving the magnet towards the coil. When the magnet is moving towards the coil, he found that the galvanometer started deflecting. That means there is some current flowing in the coil. Okay, that is first observation. Next observation is, the other observation he observed is, he moved the coil very slow. When he moved the coil very slow, he found that this deflection is very less. That is, the current flowing through the coil is very less. In the next case, what did he do? He moved the magnet very fast. When he moved the magnet very fast, he found that the deflection is very much. That is, more amount of current is flowing through the coil. Okay, next. The next observation he observed is, see, previously what did he do? He brought North Pole towards the coil. Now what did he do? The same coil, instead of bringing North Pole towards the coil, he brought South Pole towards the coil. Then what did he observe? He observed that the deflection that occurred in the galvanometer when North Pole is moved towards the coil is different from the deflection that occurs in the galvanometer. If I take the galvanometer here, okay, what he observed, when he brought South Pole towards the coil, he observed that the deflection which is occurred earlier is opposite to the deflection occurred in this case. That is, earlier when north pole is brought towards this coil, if the deflection took place towards right, now in this case when south pole is brought towards the coil, he found that the deflection in the galvanometer occurred towards left. That is, current flowed in the opposite direction. Okay, that is one point. Next, similar to this, when he moved south pole very fast, he found that deflection is more. When he moved the magnet at the south pole very slow, he found that deflection is very less. Okay, the next thing is, instead of magnet, he replaced this magnet with one more coil, same coil. He replaced this magnet with a coil with a battery. Now, when this is connected to a battery, you know that current flows through the coil. Instead of magnet, now what did he do? He moved the coil towards this coil. I'll take this coil 1, this coil 2. He moved coil 2 towards coil 1. Then he observed the same phenomena. That is, when he moved the coil very fast, the reflection is more. When he moved the coil very slow, the deflection is less. All these phenomena. So this is other observation. Now, from this observation and from this observation, we can come to a conclusion that if there is relative motion, if there is relative motion between the source of magnetic field and a coil and the coil, then we can observe that some current is induced in the coil. This phenomenon is nothing but electromagnetic induction. So once again, I'm saying the main point. If there is relative motion between the source of the magnet, in this example it is coil, in this example it is magnet. Okay, so when there is relative motion between the source of the magnetic field and the coil, what happens? And current is generated in the coil. This phenomenon is called as electromagnetic induction. Okay, the other experiment that Faraday did is, this is one coil which is connected to a galvanometer. Next, this is other coil that is in YZ plane. This is connected to a battery which is connected to a key. This is battery B, this is key K. Now, the axis of both coils are same. Both coils are in YZ plane and axis is X axis. Okay. Now, what he observed is, when he switched on the key, he observed that the galvanometer deflected and came back to its original position. Similarly, when he switched off the key, he observed again galvanometer deflecting in opposite direction and coming back. Okay, this is the other observation he observed. Now let me explain. Now, first, what did he do? He switched on the key. When he switched on the key, what happens? Current in this coil will start increasing from 0 to I, because of which there will be current in this coil. Next, when we switch off this key, the current which is I at this instant will start decreasing towards 0. That is, there is change in current. Again, he observed that there is deflection in the galvanometer. Okay, so these are the experiments conducted by Faraday. And from these observations, he said that there is some relation between, or from magnetism, we can, from magnetic field, we can produce current.